attention, people. We have a mystery on our hands. This week, the scholars in this room are the crew of a mighty ship, the Envisioneer. While in search of an ancient treasure, we were marooned on an island. And a key part of our navigational map went missing. Of the entire crew, we considered four suspects. Today, you will hear evidence collected against Dr. Nicholas Smart and shipwright Robert Neff.
After evaluating the shipwreck, many of the crewmate members were injured. One of them was Chef Stewart. He had a collapsed lung, and we had to insert a chest needle to maintain stability and relieve pressure.
Some of the crewmates had small fractures and had to be put in the splints. We also found the captain had suffered a deep cut in his head and was knocked unconscious.
In conclusion, Dr. Smart neglected his duties because of the fact he was partially in the operation.
After the injured crew were attended to, a census occurred, and we noted that Ms. Young and Mr. Neff were missing. Being unfamiliar with the terrain of the island, we sent out a drone and built a robot called M-Bot to explore the island and find the missing crew members.
Using the information from the drone, we mapped out the island to find Miss Young and Mr. Neff.
Suddenly, a flood happened and knocked down the bridge, so we had to build a replica out of the materials we had on hand. Then, the M-Bot crossed and found the missing crew.
While Miss Young was walking to the ship, she got bit by a snake. It was later identified to be a pit viper that contains hemotoxin.
Hemotoxin affects your blood. Symptoms are that the bite gets red, swollen, and bleeds. Dr. Smart wrongly diagnosed Miss Young to have hemotoxin in her system. Testimony is valid in court.
Unrelated to the snake bite, we dissected a cow's heart because it's built like a human's heart. We to help a crew member from a heart attack like symptoms.
Blood was found at the deck of the ship, so we had to go back to the lab to find more answers about what occurred.
We followed the head that the blood could have fallen from and measured the blood drop stamina.
Dr. Smart and Ned had a wound at about 30 inches in diameter.
At the scene of the crime, there was a powdery substance near the chest. We took it back to the lab to run trials to have insight of its true identity. We mixed other powders that had the same properties as the mystery substance.
We mixed it with iodine to see if it matched the reaction of the mystery substance. We discovered that it was cornstarch that can be used as an ointment or a sunscreen.
Also at the scene of the crime, there was a cup. We dusted it for fingerprints and we took it to the lab. When the results came in, they matched that of Dr. Smart.